Tinapay mula sa langit. A daily morning devotion with CRC Family.
Isang mapagpalang umaga, mga kapatid. Ako si Pastora Mary Ann Sinogba ng CRC Chess, Jose Martires City, Cavite. Samahan niyo po kami sa ating programang Tinapay Mula sa Langit, ang araw-araw nating devotion sa Salita ng Diyos. Ngayong umaga ay matutunghayan natin ang verse na ating pag-aaralan mula sa aklat ng Numbers chapter 24 verse 10 to 13. Ngunit bago po tayo magpatuloy, tayo dumako sa isang maikling panalangin. Diyos Ama, maraming salamat sa panibagong araw at patuloy na aming tinatagubili ng buong maghapon na ito sa inyong mga kamay. Maraming salamat sa kalakasan at malusog na pangangatawan na inyong ipinagkakaloob sa bawat isa. Dalangin namin na inyong patnubay sa gawain na ito at gayon din na inyong mayamang biyaya ay patuloy na sumagana sa buhay ng bawat isa upang maging bahagi ng gawain na inyong itinalaga sa inyong mga anak. Ito po ang aming dalangin sa tanging pangalan ni Jesus. Amen. Ang title po ng ating pag-aaralan for this morning is Balak's Frustration with Balaam. At akin pong babasahin ang nakasulat sa Numbers chapter 24 verse 10 to 13. Verse 10, then Balak became furious with Balaam, struck his hands together and said to him, I summon you to put a curse on my enemies, but instead you have blessed them these three times. Verse 11, now go to your home. I said I would reward you richly, but look, the Lord has denied you a reward. Verse 12, Balaam answered Balak, didn't I previously tell the messengers you sent me? Verse 13, if Balak were to give me his house full of silver and gold, I could not go against the Lord's command to do anything good or bad of my own will. I will say whatever the Lord says. Amen. Ang Numbers 24, verse 10 to 13, tells us the story of Balaam and Balak when the Israelites were traveling their way to the Promised Land. The Israelites at that time were known for all the miracles and victories God bestowed upon them from the time they left Egypt. The people of every city they go and pass through know that God was on the side of the Israelites. Balak himself, king of Moab, witnessed the victory of Israelites over the Amorites, as it is written in Numbers 22, verse 2 to 3, Moab dreaded the Israelites. This is the reason why Balak wanted to weaken the Israelites, and his scheme was for Balaam to curse Israel. However, as we read earlier in verse 10 of Numbers 24, Balaam, instead of cursing Israel, he actually blessed them for three times. And this is frustrating for Balak. For three times, he expected to see Israel's defeat, but to no avail. Worse is, they have been blessed all the more through Balaam. And on verse 11, Balak withdrew the promised reward for Balaam. Frustrated as he is, he wants Balaam to go home. And the words of Balak on verse 11, but look, the Lord has denied you a reward, is the usual scheme of Satan over God's people. The same kind of deceiving tactics was used by the serpent against Adam and Eve. In our story, Balak twisted the truth. Instead of him pulling out the rewards he promised to Balaam, he blamed God for not wanting to reward Balaam. His objective was to create hate, doubt, in the heart of Balaam for him to eventually curse the Israelites. Jesus said in John 10:10, a thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come so that they may have life and have it in abundance. Satan steals the truth of the Word of God in our hearts until we are spiritually dead and destroyed. But if we obey God's Word, His promise is for us to have life and have it in abundance. However, sometimes we choose to ignore the Word of God and instead we focus our eyes on the reward promised by this world. Like Balaam, he chose to proceed with his plans Despite God saying no because his eyes are set on the reward promised by Balak, which later on brought destruction. As Christians, we should set our eyes on the reward promised by God so that in this journey of ours, no matter how many Balak we meet along the way, we will not be enticed by anything he offers us. Rather, we stand firm on the word of God. Frustration is failed expectation. No one else in this world is more reliable than God. If we put our trust in him and we align our life with his word, we will never fail and more so feel frustrated. It is written in 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3 to 4, his divine power has given us everything required for life and godliness through the knowledge of him who called us by his own glory and goodness. By this, he has given us very great and precious promises so that through them you may share in the divine nature, escaping the corruption that is in the world because of evil desire. To God be the glory. Indeed, O Lord, we thank you for all the promises you have given us. Give us the courage and the grace to hold on to these promises and make it happen in our lives to be a great testimony for the glory of your name. Keep each one of us from frustration and teach us to trust only in your words. Teach us to be patient and enduring as we wait for the fulfillment of your promises in our lives. This we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pakikibahagi sa ating programa. Lagi po nating pagnilayan ang salita ng Diyos mula sa ating puso dahil lubos ang magiging kaunawaan natin dito. Muli po ninyo kaming samahan bukas sa pagninilay ng kanyang mga salita sa programang Tinapay Mula sa Langit. Malaya po ninyong i-share ang video na ito upang kayo rin ay maging pagpapala sa iba. Pagpalain po tayong lahat ng ating Panginoon. Magandang umaga. Amen.